were of this world, my servants who certainly strive that I should not be delivered to the Jews. But now my kingdom is not from hence. Pilate therefore said to me, Art thou a king then? Jesus answered, Thou sayest that I am a king. For this was I born, and for this came I into the world, that I should give testimony to the truth. Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice. Please be seated. Your Excellency, Most Reverend Bishop Keene, welcome to St. Joseph's. We are so very grateful and joyful you're here with us today to celebrate this feast of Christ the King in the extraordinary form. Thank you for honoring us and leading us into the liturgy. I remind all of you, please be sure that each Sunday you take a bulletin of our parish so you're able to be involved in the wider St. Joseph community. And a reminder that this week we have two special days that we celebrate. The extraordinary formal assist us in celebrating the Feast of All Saints on Tuesday at noon in the extraordinary formal All Saints Day, a holy day of obligation. In addition, All Souls Day, Wednesday, November 2nd, a sung Requiem Mass will be offered on Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. here at St. Joseph's. Next Sunday, November 6th, the extraordinary formal will be held in the lower church because of the liturgy that we'll be preparing for here in the upper church that afternoon, remembering all those who died here at St. Joseph's in the last 12 months.
Father, well, thank you so very much for your words of welcome, and thank you for facilitating this transition of the extraordinary forum here to St. Joseph's. I hope that it's been a smooth transition. This church is so magnificent and so appropriate for the celebration of our Latin liturgy. So thank you for making that so easy for us. And I want to thank Father Chow in a very special way for all of us. First of all, the invitation and all of the preparations that he's done personally to make it possible. Great joy to be with you and to offer this holy sacrifice of Mass on the feast of Christ the King. I think I'm losing this one. Keep my head still. Pilate knew what kings were. The much more familiar than we are. Today there are very few monarchs left, and they are, as far as I know, all constitutional monarchs. Their power, the scope of their authority, is limited by a constitution that they or their predecessors have accepted. We have no absolute monarchs left, to my knowledge. There are totalitarian leaders of governments that are most oppressive as absolute monarchs could have been, but in terms of kings and queens, they are all limited, circumscribed authority by their constitutions. But not so in our Lord's day. Pilate understood what the absolute power of monarchs was. He understood that it was passed down from father to son in most kingdoms. And there was only one other way to bring that passing on of absolute authority, and that was a revolution, to forcefully seize the kingship from the heir who should have received it. And that, I think, is what was in Pilate's mind, why he had to get to the bottom of whatever was going on with this man from Nazareth. And he asks him, "Are you a king?" And our Lord tells him very clearly, I think, in that context, "My kingdom is not of this world. My kingdom doesn't work the way worldly kingdoms work. This authority I'm not seizing from the emperor or from Herod. My authority supersedes theirs completely. My kingdom comes from God. I am the truth." Pilate asks, not in the gospel here, but what is true? He could say, who is true? It was Jesus, who is the way, the truth, and the life, that stood before the Roman government. Our Lord assures him that this kingdom is quite different. St. Paul, in his letter to the Colossians, our first reading today, gives us the scope of our Lord's kingship. It is not even just universal throughout the world, but it is cosmic. It is universal throughout all of God's creation. Jesus has the authority. Jesus is King, eternal and universal. So it is that the Church, with great joy, recognizes the kingship of Christ, and we celebrate it on this feast day. For you and for me, the important thing is that Jesus reigns in our hearts, and Jesus reigns over our lives as we go about the ordinary routines of our days, in married and family life, in the works that we do, in the homes that we have, in the neighborhoods, in our church, in the place of work, that Christ truly is King, and that the lives that you and I lead make that evident. May no one doubt who has universal authority and power over us and over our lives. It is the Lord Jesus Christ, universal King. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever.
gospel be schooled.
Oh.
Grande Prophetess.
Thank you.
Thank you. honors of this school.
Given 50 seconds.